What's up, NFL fans? I'm Emery Hunt, the czar of the playbook, and don't forget to check out and purchase your copy of our latest football game plan book, Stiff Arming Football Myths. We have these available in both PDF and paperback form. Welcome to FootballGamePlan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emery Hunt, the czar of the playbook, bringing you my 2015 NFL Draft Prospect Rankings video. We're taking a look at the center position. We're going to look at my top 10, some small school prospects, as well as some sleepers that you want to keep an eye on.
First, let's take a look at what goes into my prospect rankings. Number one, it's a trait focus base instead of a level of competition base. I don't care where you play, traits translate. Now look at three games, your best game, a player's worst game, and also the best matchup and or competition. And finally, these are not indicative of where I believe these players will actually go in April's draft. Andy Gallick out of Boston College is a very strong point of attack player that doesn't allow any penetration. He moves extremely well, and I came away highly impressed with his ability to seal, scoop, and reach block. Now, he's also able to diagnose and pick up stunts, blitzes, and twists very well. The one thing he'll have to work on is that at times he can get caught reaching and lunging, which causes him to miss blocks. Those are few and far in between. I think he's the cleanest center prospect in the country and definitely worthy of a first-round grade. Cam Irving out of Florida State at 6'5", 313, started his career as a left tackle, came into the season as a highly touted left tackle prospect, moved down inside the center, and he excelled tremendously. He was able to bend, he explodes his hips and redirects in a running game, and you know he excels in pass pro. He initiates contact and has that tremendous upside, seeing that this is his first year playing the center position. Again, he still gives two-way goals versus stunts, which means he doesn't shut the door and is allowing defensive guys to get inside on different stunts and different blitzes. He'll have to get better with that, but like I said, that comes with time, and that's why I said he has that upside, but plays a lot like Travis Frederick of the Dallas Cowboys. B.J. Finney out of Kansas State at 6'4", 323 pounds. I've graded out as a second-round prospect. Plays a lot like Jeremy Zuta of the Baltimore Ravens. He's able to lock and extend. He initiates contact, which I'm big on. He has strong hands and recovers very well. Now, he's not as athletic as you'd like, and he plays high at times. He'll clean up that pad level. If he can do that, he'll definitely maximize his potential moving forward. At number four, I have Matthew Reese out of Tuskegee, a Division II program. This is a guy that can play both center as well as guard. At 6'3", 310 pounds, he plays a lot like Jonathan Goodwin of the New Orleans Saints. He has a very strong punch. He's functionally strong. His hands stay inside. He can excel, like I said before, at guard or center, and he plays with a nasty attitude that you like. Now, he'll need a year of pro conditioning because I think he can get better physically with his body. He's inconsistent versus quick rushers and stunts. I think those things he can improve on as a pro, but overall, he has enough skill set to make the jump from Division II to the NFL and stick for a very long time. I got the chance to see Trevor Sales live versus UMass, and here's a guy that climbs to the second level very well and does an outstanding job in finishing his blocks. His footwork is excellent at the position, and his feet continue to move throughout the process, which allows him to be able to control and block through the whistle. He's also able to execute many of the blocks you want to see, your scoops, your traps, full block, seal, combo, and pull. Sales can do it all except cut blocking. Don't allow him to cut block and you won't have any problems with this game. I think this is a solid prospect being underrated right now that can also play guard if need be. Reese Dismukes out of Auburn had a highly decorated career. He's able to pin and seal very well. He's a good athlete that climbs to the second level with ease, and he understands combo blocking. Now, he's not functionally strong. He needs to explode into his blocks, and his hands tend to get outside, which could cause a lot of holding at the next level. But overall, I compare his game to Chris Myers that plays for the Houston Texans. I think Dismukes could excel in a zone blocking scheme. Jaronis Grassu out of Oregon is able to anchor and hold a point. He moves well, and he's able to stonewall pressure. All three, in my opinion, are great traits to have to be a professional center at the highest level. Now, the one thing he has to get better, he has to start to redirect a little bit better. He struggles to redirect opponents, and his feet die upon engagement. That can't happen as a pro, and he's not functionally strong. But I think with improved pad level, a lot of this can be cleared up, which is why I still think he can be a solid starter at the NFL level. Shaq Mason out of Georgia Tech is one of my favorite players in the draft. This is a guy that plays a lot like Brian Stork, who came out of Florida State last year as a highly decorated center prospect. Mason is versatile. He's extremely quick off the ball. He climbs well and is able to wall off, pin effectively. And I think he allows creativity in your offense because he can play guard as effectively as he plays the center position. The problem is he tends to duck his head. He's inconsistent with his hand placement, I think mostly in the pass pro department because he hasn't seen a lot of it at Georgia Tech. Those are some things he'll have to work on moving forward. Another underrated prospect in this year's draft class is David Fredrickson out of Wagner. Got the chance to see him live versus Alderson Brodus back in October, and he's a fifth-year senior and a team captain. He has very good read and recognition skills when it comes to diagnosing and picking up different blitzes and stunts. He does allow at times his hands to get outside, which could lead to holding calls as he moves forward. That has definitely become better, but he does a lot of things very well. He position blocks well. He climbs to the second level very well. He plays the piano, so to speak, very well. Now, pad level is another concern that you have with this game, and he plays a little high at times. He's not a bender, but does have the athleticism to recover and redirect. I think this is a guy that can make a roster and be a solid contributor, whether it be as a guard or as a center in a zone blocking scheme. Jake Smith out of Louisville is a very good athlete that extends well. He initiates contact, and he also does a great job in keeping his feet on the move. Now, he can be late to diagnose different stunts and delayed pressures, and he struggles to reset versus counter moves. I think he's also not as stout as you like at the position, but he also plays guard. So, again, very good athlete, I think, can also excel in either a power game or a zone blocking scheme and plays a lot like J.C. Tretter of the Green Bay Packers. Mike Marbo out of Idaho might be the strongest center in this year's draft class. He's naturally and functionally strong. He plays with good leverage and read recognition skills of where it needs to be. He definitely moves the defender off the spot. Now, he struggles with lateral movement. He's not sudden or explosive. But if I had to compare someone's game to Mike Marbo's, it would probably be Dominic Raiola of the Detroit Lions. Greg Mantz out of Toledo is a guy that has great footwork on full blocks and pulls. He's a solid point of attack player and also has good frame. He plays a lot like Eric Wood of the Buffalo Bills. I want to see him explode his hips a little bit more and run his feet while he's engaged with the defender. He doesn't bend well. I think he has to become much more flexible in order to have a long, sustained career as a pro. Dylan Day out of Mississippi State plays with a lot of passion. He moves well laterally. He has good initial pop upon contact. He seals and pins well, and I like his football awareness. He's good right there in that aspect. Now, he needs to roll his hips into his blocks, and he also struggles to reset and redirect defenders upon contact. I think those are the two areas where he'll have to improve moving forward. Jesse Hines out of North Dakota State put together a very solid career for the Bison at 6'4", 301 pounds. I came away highly impressed with his technique and his footwork, and I think he can play in either an off-tackle or power scheme, even as a zone blocking center at the next level. Shane McDermott out of Miami plays the piano very well. He recognizes stunts and pressures, and he does a great job in pinning and sealing defenders. Now, his footwork is inconsistent. He struggles with second-level blocks, and he's not stout at the point of attack. If he can get stronger in his lower half, I think he does have a lot of upside moving forward. Derek Schatz is a former Villanova Wildcat that transferred to Westchester in 2013. He position blocks very well and is able to lock and turn the defender. He gets his hands inside consistently and does a great job in passing guys off and assisting with double teams. He has good read and recognition skills, but I didn't see the athleticism to think he can also play guard. He's strictly a center, but the biggest positive I took away about his game is that he's able to consistently move guys off the spot in the running game. Alex Mateus out of UConn at 6'4", 309. I got the chance to see live versus SMU. He's also a Canadian Football League draft prospect born in Ottawa. He does a very good job of attacking and winning the hands battle consistently. He has good initial punch, and his feet are constantly moving, which allows him to not only get position, but also leverage. Now, he moves well on pulls and screens. He keeps his hands inside at all times, which is textbook. I questioned his anchoring ability. Many times he wasn't anchoring. He was playing too high and getting knocked off balance. Now, I do think he can excel as a left guard if need be. So let's recap my 2015 NFL Draft prospect rankings for the center position. This is a great year for centers. Last year, I only graded out 8 or 9 guys as draftable prospects. This year, we have 17, and these are color-coded by round grade, with red being first round. Only 2 first-round center prospects. That's Andy Gaelic out of Boston College and Cam Irving out of Florida State. and there's no six-round graded prospects. We go from fifth to seventh, but overall, all 17 guys I wouldn't have a problem with on my offensive line.